headline: Traders in pains as army set houses, shops on fire in Imo to revenge death of colleague killed by unknown gunmen. Thank you for tuning in to this news. Thank you for listening and for sharing and clicking on the subscribe button. But if you haven't, please kindly click on the subscribe button and the bell for more notifications of the news. Now to the news details. Men suspected to be military men have allegedly burnt down properties in Awo Umama, Uru East local government area of Imo State, after gunmen killed a soldier. Social media user Emeka Gift, who shared the photos and the videos of the burning houses and shops, said the incident occurred shortly after the soldiers had a confrontation with some unknown gunmen who were enforcing the Monday sit-at-home order. According to him, the unknown gunmen killed an army officer. After the confrontation and revenging the killing, the soldiers began setting ablaze houses and shops in area. According to Punch, gunmen on Monday afternoon killed a military officer when they attacked some soldiers at Isheke Junction in the community. In reprisal, soldiers regrouped, invaded the town, and allegedly burnt down a hotel, shops, and houses. According to a source, many indigenous of the community are fled as soldiers took over the community. Some hoodlums attacked some soldiers at Isheke Junction in Awo Umama and killed one of them. They zoomed off towards Iyala in Anambra State. Later, soldiers invaded the area and caused havoc in the area, setting a hotel, cars, houses, and stores on fire, the sources said. After the killing in Imo State, the soldiers came back and set ablaze houses, shops. The residents desert Imo community as unknown gunmen attack Nigerian soldiers, kill one. Gunmen on Monday afternoon killed a military officer when they attacked some soldiers in Awo Umama in the Oru East local government area of Imo State. In reprisal, military men regrouped, stormed the town, and allegedly burnt a hotel, cars, houses, and shops. Some of the hoodlums attacked some soldiers at Isheke Junction in Umama and killed one of them. Imo State has been experiencing a series of attacks lately, especially on security formations. On April 5, armed men invaded the headquarters of the Imo State Police Command and the Nigeria Correctional Service in Owerri, burnt the facilities, and freed over 1,800 inmates. Unfortunately, one person suspected to be a fleeing prison inmate was hit by a stray bullet. Few days after, the country home of the state governor, Ope Uzodinma, in Omuma, Oru East local government area of the state, was invaded by gunmen. During the attack, they burnt part of the building and raised some vehicles in the compound, killing at least a security official. This incident this insecurity in the Imo State is becoming alarming day by day. The people are living in fear. They can't move around the way they're supposed to. Unknown governments are always invading. They are always invading the Imo State. And now, few days ago, they killed an army after some unknown gunmen were seen in the southeast, and this army were there to curb this insecurity. Then those troops shot at an army. Those hoodlums were seen enforcing illegitimate stay-at-home order. And this has been confirmed by Major Abubakar Abdullahi, the acting deputy director, Army Public Relations 82 Division. This happened on Tuesday, November 23. Criminals indulge in harassment, intimidation of commuters going about their businesses in the quest to compel citizens to comply with the unlawful order. The criminals went further to carry out arson and destruction of businesses, homes and vehicles in areas including Ishike Junction and towards Onitsha, as a vendetta against the citizens for not complying. Vigilant troops responding to distress calls swiftly moved to the scene and engaged the hoodlums in a firefight, forcing them to scamper in different directions. The 82 Division spokesman noted that a member of the group was neutralized in the shootout, adding that a gallant soldier paid the supreme price after troops pursued the hoodlums to their hideout in Akata community. Because of that, the army came back and set ablaze hotel, houses, shops, stores on fire. Does this warrant what the army did? One of them was killed. They are the ones that are protecting the lives of those people. Are they supposed to be involved in destroying of properties? Please, kindly share your view with us on this. Have a blessed day.